makes you feel a little weird, though, baby.
And I come into you. Those are the words.
Oh boy. Hey guys. It's Saturday morning. I forgot to upload my weekly vlog thing, so and I refuse to do it until I finish Perks of Being a Wallflower. I fell asleep while reading it, but again, it's such an easy read. And it's 8:30 in the morning on Saturday, so I feel like I just have to go grocery. I really want to go grocery shopping today. I usually go like when it's too late, but I'm trying to like meal prep and get all my food ready today or tomorrow so that during the week my life is a little bit easier. I do think that, sorry, this has literally nothing to do with anything. Hello guys. But typically I feel like my work weeks can vary so much, and I think I just got smashed this past week where like I worked not as many days, but the days that I did work were like 10 to 12 hour days. And so I just had not a lot of energy left to cook at the end of the day. But I feel like this coming week, my days are going to be a lot shorter, like work days. So I probably will be able to cook, but it's kind of nice. I really appreciate it, just having to like heat food up during the week. So anyways, where do I even start this video? All right. So, yesterday we went to our friend Josh's, he had an art show opening, and I'm really annoyed because I forgot to film his art. He is so incredible. I've shown his work, and I think on my channel before, but I'll link his like Instagram or his website below. He is so talented. The things that he does with like lighting and color and just like, he's so talented. So please go check him out. I will post him. I'll link him below. I should probably also, I kind of want to include Jake. This is one of Jake's pieces. Jake's links in my, like, at the bottom, you know, when you open the description, there's like my Goodreads and Letterboxd and all that. I kind of want to add Jake's, like, an art link for Jake at the bottom, just like to have there all the time. So anyways, again, right, I forgot to film that. I did film Lloyd and John kind of playing chess a little bit, but that was, I think, at the very beginning, so I wasn't getting crazy yet. And yeah, I guess that was it that I needed to say. I didn't even need to say any of that, but that's okay. So goal is to drink coffee, finish Perks of Being a Wallflower, go grocery shopping, do the upload, and maybe like pre-film of a tag to post like in a day or two. I was tagged in some things, and I'm always really, really bad at doing tags, but I want to be a person who's good at them now that I know how to insert pictures of things. I don't have to like search for books on my shelves and take them out. So that's nice. Maybe I will hopefully do that too.
You found a new spot, baby.
You're such a cutie.
I am honestly starting to get really irritated with this book. The main character has a teacher named Bill that like keeps giving him books to read because of whatever reason, because he gets on with him. And, you know, he gives him, I think, I don't know, like, where it starts, but the most recent one that he gave him was On the Road, and I feel like he read it in less than a month, and it was, like, a reward for him. And the second I read that, I was like, if he gives him Naked Lunch too, I'm gonna be really irritated. And sure enough, the next book to read, it's called Naked Lunch. I don't know if y'all have read either of those books, but I have. And they're the most difficult books I have ever read in my life. And this kid writes these letters like he is 10 years old. I just do not. I'm honestly so annoyed right now. I'm so, so annoyed. Okay, so I finished The Perks of Being a Wallflower by Stephen Chbosky. Yeah, this was fine. So I am going to, I think, make a snack or something. And then maybe read more of Jane Eyre. I don't know. Or maybe I'm going to start something else. We'll see. I'll let you know once it happens.
Hey guys. So I have started, it's Sunday morning, by the way. I started Platitudes by Trey Ellis, and oh my goodness, I am loving this. This is so good so far. It is extremely meta. It's just so funny. I'm really, really loving it. I'm just irritated because I was like, oh, I mean, I'm only I'm 18 pages into the book, so I barely have started it, but I want to read more by this author because I'm enjoying it so much. And so I searched in Powell's and Book Depository. Those are like the two places that I usually search for books. And he has like, it looks like three books. So Platitudes, Right Here, Right Now, and Home Repairs are like the three that are popping up. And all of them cost over $20. I mean, less than 25, but they all cost more than 20 bucks. And I'm like so annoyed because, you know, that's kind of a lot of money to spend on a paperback. Especially like, look how teeny this book is. So we'll see. Obviously not something that I'm going to do like in the near future, but I think in the eventual future, I will have to acquire them because at least based on my enjoyment of this so far, I'm honestly like, it's so, so good. Jake and I just finished Saturday Night Fever, and I've got to say that movie really, really upset me a lot. John Travolta's dancing was phenomenal, and it was glorious to watch, but the rest of the movie does not make up for it at all. It was really depressing. Making cinnamon raisin swirl bread, and I've just finished my second proof, and this thing is too big. It's so chubby. Oh, look at that. Look at that. These little babies keep attacking my feet. It's 6 o'clock in the morning. I do need to wake up for work right now. So, it's not terrible, but I'm just trying to relax. You guys are crazy. I know it's misleading because they look so cute and calm right now. But I promise you, they're vicious. Guys, it is... Oh, my coffee's over here. It's Wednesday, July 17th. I'm listening to Democracy Now! And hearing all about what's happening with Pantaleo. And I'm so frustrated and annoyed. I will link that below if I remember. I did want to mention that I read a little, I was going to say quite a bit more. Not really. I read more of Jane Eyre at work yesterday. This is honestly the perfect workbook. It's just so easy to read. I am confused because right now Mr. Rochester has all these people over at his house and they're like having some weird games. and like, it's kind of like charades, except way more involved. So, and of course, Jane Eyre is getting super jealous because there's like a girl that she thinks that Mr. Rochester wants to marry. But like, hello, it's called Jane Eyre. You're going to marry him. Don't worry, sweetheart. and then a little bit before bed, I read more of Platitudes by Trey Ellison. I am honestly, this book is so fantastic. It's so meta. It's so weird. There's so many things happening in this book. And it's so tiny and I'm so annoyed that I'm finished. I think I have like 40 pages left. I was hoping to sit down and finish it before I had to go for work, before I had to leave for work, but I have to leave in like 30 minutes. So I might try it anyways, just for fun. If I'm like not there perfectly on time, it won't be the end of the world. So yeah, this is so good. If any of you have read Trey Ellis, please let me know. I'm curious if his other books are like this too. It's so good. Hey guys, it's Thursday morning. I literally am... I'm on page 179 and this book is 183 pages. And I just passed out last night. I could not keep my eyes open. I was trying so hard, so I might have to backtrack and read like an extra page. I ran out of space on my phone, so that's not good because I'm going on a trip this weekend. Anyways, so I'm just hopefully gonna finish this right now. I need to finish it. I finished. I loved this, and now I have to get some food ready for work. maybe I will have time to read Jane Eyre at work. Who knows? I'll let you know. Hey guys, it's Friday morning. I'm flying to LA later today. Last night I did start The Storm by Tomas Gonzalez, translated by Andrea Rosenberg. And I got like 26 pages into it, and I'm not sure that I love it. I'm really disappointed. I think it's an issue with the translator though. So my problem is the writing. I feel like it's I don't know. I'm not a huge fan. There was like one part where, so the story is about two twins and they're going out on the boat with their dad. And so we're kind of introduced to one of them first, and he's like, oh, he was born 2 hours after his brother, but like wish he'd never been born. And then like the next page, it like says, it like clarifies that, oh, they're twins, but it's like, yeah, I didn't need you to tell me that. So, but maybe I'm just being a little snobby. I don't know. I just don't think the writing is like spectacular. It kind of reminds me of like YA. But there's like really high praise for this book on the like jacket, and it's not that long. So I'm just going to read it. And it's like a new book that I just bought very recently. So I'm going to read it. Who knows? Maybe the book will surprise me. All right, so it's of course super late. It's almost, well, I guess it's only 1:30 right now, but I need to leave for the airport in like 2 hours. I still haven't done my vlog yet or like my update, and I haven't packed and I haven't showered. So got tons of stuff to do. I assume this is the last you'll be seeing of me until next week. Goodbye. Hey guys, okay, so this is gonna be hopefully super, super quick because I still have tons of stuff to do and now it's 2:00. So this is like, I feel like really live time. You know, I had to edit the bits. I said I was gonna link a bunch of stuff down below in the clips. I am 100% not gonna do that unless I have time. So if you're dying to know what I was talking about, let me know. The only thing that I feel really guilty about is Josh. I'd love to link him, but we'll see. Hopefully I have time. So the books that I'm bringing with me on my trip are The Storm, which I have started and am not super sold on, but again, oh, there's a bookmark in here already. Again, I just bought it, so I feel like a lot of, like, you know, like I should give it more of a chance. Plus, this is like a new, I mean, it's probably not a new publisher, but this is the first time that I've read any Archipelago books, and this is the first time that I've read this author, so I am curious. And I think somewhere on here, see, Gonzalez's last two novels, Difficult Light and The Storm, were both hailed as quiet masterpieces at the time of their publication in Colombia. So, I don't know. I'm going to read it, and I do kind of think that if I don't get on with it, that I'm going to attempt to read it in Spanish and see if it is an issue with the translator, because based on the writing, I do kind of think that it's a translation issue, which is unfortunate. The other books that I'm bringing, way too many books, but I'm planning on having like a, you know, beach day Sunday by myself before like doing other things. So hopefully I have time to read at least a little bit, but I am going to be bringing Jane Eyre with me. I'm on page 256 and I think it's it's like close to 600 pages, I think. So I'm shy of the halfway point. But I would like to finish it before the end of the month. And I'd also like to finish Monster Human by Kirsty Skolmsvold, translated by Becky L. Crook. This I haven't really picked up at all since a long time ago. It's only like 450 pages though, and I'm 100 pages into it, so I think that if I put some effort into it, it could happen. Also, I forgot to mention the translator for this is Andrea Rosenberg. Michael, before you start bitching in the comments, I'm going to be bringing Surfacing by Margaret Atwood. My goal, I would like to finish both of these on this trip.
And then the other ones I'd just like to work on. But I'm coming back Monday morning super early, which is the first day of the reading rush. And so I'm going to be bringing Object Lessons, The Paris Review Presents, The Art of the Short Story with me so I can start this on Monday. So those other ones I'm going to be attempting to read. I don't know why I always bring too many books with me. But there you go. Almost made it without an email. So those are all the books that I'm bringing with me on this trip, which is, I know, absurd because tomorrow I'm going to be with people all day long. It's mostly like for Sunday day and my plane rides. Anyways, if you've read any of these, if you have any thoughts, please let me know. I'll talk to you guys next week. Bye-bye.